Hey guys, it's Sarah here from Ninja Fitness and I've got our Movement Monday challenge for today. So today's movement challenge is all about jumping and we're going to measure how good you can jump in three different ways. So first of all is about agility and speed, the second one is about how high you can jump, and the third one is about how far you can jump. So to measure our agility, you're going to need a stick, or I've got a hurl here which you could use instead. So very simply, I'm just going to put the hurl down on the grass. And with 2 feet together, I'm going to jump over and back across the hurl for 30 seconds. And I'm going to keep counting in my head how many times I can jump over and back across. Okay? So your 2 feet have to be together. And you can't touch off the hurl. You're trying to jump over and back across cleanly as quickly as you can. I'm going to use my phone here for a 30-second timer to see how many I can do. Okay? Are we ready? One, two, three. That wasn't bad. Okay, so this time we're jumping for height and we're going to measure how high up off the ground we can jump. So to do this, you're going to need some toilet rolls or anything that you can stack one on top of the other. I've just gone for these because, well, you know, we love them here at Ninja Fitness and they're the easiest thing probably that you can find stackable around your house. To make sure that there's no cheating, you need to keep your 2 feet together and your 2 feet need to go over the top of your stack. So obviously it would be really easy to jump over the big piles if we were doing a jump like this. So you have to jump with 2 feet together up over the top like that. You might have seen in our lesson last week about doing good jumping. If you haven't, just a quick tip would be to make sure that you're up on your toes and you bend right down to the ground, swinging your arms back and then swinging them up when you jump up to help you get higher off the ground. For this one, we're jumping up over something. So obviously to get higher up, we need to kind of, it's like a tuck jump, we're bringing our feet up over the top. So pumping the arms and bringing the knees up to chest to get up over the pot. So we'll start off with one. I think I've already done this already, nice and easy. One. Take that, that was 7, definitely. So I think I maxed out at 7 there. Let us know how many you get. Alright guys, so for our third jump, we're going to see how far we can jump. So again, using the same toilet rolls, you're going to start off at 1, jump over it, then 2, 3, so on and so forth. To keep this fair, we're not using any run up at all. You have to start from standing. So the same as before, we're up on our tippy toes, swinging the arms behind. But this time, we're not going for height, so instead of bringing knees to chest, we're going to try and push our legs out in front of us. If you've ever seen in the Olympics people that are doing the long jump, you'll see that they do this to get an extra bit of length. So I'll just show you a quick example. So you're swinging the arms back, and when we jump, I'm going to push my legs forwards like that. So you're getting to jump a little bit further. Okay? So here's my first toilet roll. Should be easy peasy. And remember, 2 feet together, and we need to go over the top. We don't want to see any straddle jumps. Oh, we are getting close. Maybe no toilet roll closer. Oh, I have to try that one again, I'd say. That's definitely it. Everyone wants to see me fall. Okay. Oh my god. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 17, 18. 19 toilet rolls. Nineteen is the maximum amount of toilet rolls that I can jump over. Well, there's three great activities for you guys to try at home, so let us know how many jumps you got over and back, how many toilet rolls you could jump over the top. Did she just pee at the toilet rolls? Let us know how many you guys got and tag us in your attempts. Bye guys!